Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We are at Cars and Coffee South Lake today. And again, I'm parking up here. A little bit earlier though, so the line wasn't as long when I got here, which is nice because I don't really like to stand in the tail end of something like that because if someone is not paying attention, bad stuff happens. But I hear the sounds of Cars and Coffee. Go ahead and cross here. Some people over here are doing the smart thing. They take that turnaround up here so they don't have to wait in line. Smart, smart thinking. So there's something that I really wanted to talk about real quickly, is that I had some of you guys ask for merch. Now I had 10,000 subscribers. It's a whole lot of hassle because you have to put in like taxes and all that other stuff. And then if I were to buy like, say 100 jet tags, how many am I truly gonna sell? You know? And then I'm still having to deal with the whole tax ID and all that other BS beyond that. So I'm not gonna do that. There might be something if I hit, let's see, 100,000 subscribers. There we go, there's that line. So it pays off to be here just about 15 minutes early so you don't have to deal with that. So now we're gonna go out to the show. And as always, we'll see what we can see. right, guys, so before we end up going into the car and talking about the show, there's some parking lot gold that wasn't here when I left here, so I gotta double check this. Dude. An AMX? Huh. The stuff that you see, right? So while the slider shots of that gorgeous Cobra are rolling right now, that AMX is parked over there. The one that drove by on the trailer, so I'm gonna look a little bit closer. I'm just gonna kind of look at it real quick, because I think this is a Javelin. I'm not that well versed. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong, but it's just sick to see something like that, because I think it's about to be rescued. Someone's gonna give this car the attention that it deserves, and it's gonna be freaking amazing, because one of the cool things is that you just don't see them at all anywhere, not at car shows, nowhere. And it is so cool to be able to see this right here, right now. I mean, it is rough. Probably pulled out someone's barn. It's a 304, so it's a smaller engine. And I think the coolest thing about that, it has this freaking great body line. Very muscular. So it is a Javelin. Let's see, that interior is actually not too bad. You know, it needs to have a headline, a bunch of other parts, the dash. But look at the seats. It's a diamond in the rough, this car. Back end also, very muscular look. And every car has a beautiful side. This is definitely the better side on this one. Just look at it. Let's walk back here, give you the full picture. That, ladies and gentlemen, is beautiful. You can kind of see that side profile just a little bit better up here. Coke bottle shapes for days. That is cool as hell. You know, I love show cars, but that, just something like that, you know, just bring it back alive. I think that is the coolest thing ever. Anyway, we're gonna go to the car. We're gonna talk about the rest of the show. Alrighty, guys, we're back in the car. Favorite of show. That's actually the first car that I saw right as I walked on the show, and that was the FD RX-7. Still rotary powered, which is always a plus one for me, and it looked great, especially under the hood. It looked absolutely awesome, and it also did seem like it was built for more than just a road car, which is very, very cool. Also have to mention SVT Bird. She got her hood redone. It looks freaking amazing with the sparkles going on. I hope that the camera did it justice, because I always love to see the older cars versus the newer ones. So shooting wise, I kind of did a little bit of everything. I didn't really come in with a set plan. Also was very busy, so it was very hard to get the shots clean of shadows and stuff like that. So I really hope that I got enough footage, because I kind of went to the exit early on. Exit, very busy. There was a ton of people there. You know, I remember when I first started shooting here and the first couple of shows, I was just there by myself. I just now look at it. Everywhere there's people. Great sense. However, before the exhaust noises come in, there was wind. So I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. We'll have to wait and see. I really hope that if this doesn't give me a ton of wind noise, I'm never gonna mention it again, ever. I promise. I probably will, though. That's like the standard thing. Every single time you complain about the wind. Yes, I do. Yes, I do, because it is something to complain about. I should have put the AC on, because it actually warmed up nicely as well. I had my first sweat drop when I was walking the show, and I'm like, okay, it is coming, man. It is coming. We are going to get hot up in here. Cool cars, though. That was a Lambo. You can't see it because the camera probably doesn't. Yeah, definitely can't see it, because this car has a little bit of rake up and you get headrests in the way. But anyway, all in all, I think it's been a great show. Not too many crazy people. One guy did a burnout, I think, in a Camaro. I didn't catch it, which is, you know, it is what it is. Whatever. I wish people would just not do that, because we're going to get screwed. One of these days, there's going to be a cop at that exit, and we are all hosed because of behavior like that. So, yeah, we'll wait and see on that one. But anyway, there's one other thing that I need to talk to you guys about, and that is the subscriber level. You already know that the channel hit 10,000 subscribers, which I'm very stoked. But now, of course, we're going to go beyond that. But YouTube, in their infinite wisdom, decided that as soon as you end up with 10,000 subscribers, people are not interested in seeing the
the factor of 10 or just the single subscribers. No, they're only interested in seeing you tick up like an extra 100 subscribers, which for me, it takes a while for me to get there. So I want to kind of give you the accurate number every time. And I want to do that at the beginning of the video, but I forgot. So now you're going to get it at the tail end. So let me go ahead and look this up real quick. I think it's 10,125, but I could be wrong. Ooh, I was off by one. I overstated myself. 10,124. By the time this goes up, it's probably going to be more. I don't hope it's less. Anyway, you guys take care. Outtakes are coming up, and I'll see you guys on the flip side. Oh, man. Okay. Just for a little bit of an outtake, I always check out the comments, right? And the number one video, which is that V6 supercharged Challenger, much to my dismay because I want a V8 up there, but we'll just leave that at that. I love the fact that it has that many views and people are still commenting on it, even after a couple of years. So, because it's a Challenger, right? So this guy, Rare Air 24, he says, "That a rather nice boat you got there, sir." It's a fact, man. It's a fact. Throughout the entire range, from the V6 all the way to the Demon, they are just freaking boats. They're heavy as hell. But they sound great. That is the takeaway with all those Mopars, except for the V6. They just sound freaking glorious, especially if you just do an exhaust delete or a mid-muffler delete. It becomes a great-sounding car. Just a fact. Just a fact. Anyway, outtakes coming up right now.